Seattle FBI agents moved in on Wednesday night to encircle the last four holdouts at a federal wildlife refuge in eastern Oregon that has been occupied since early January by armed anti-government militants. Negotiations continued into the night, the FBI said in a statement, and no shots had been fired. But in a live phone feed that streamed for several hours on YouTube with tens of thousands of listeners, the occupiers said they believed that the government agents had closed in to kill them. They said that they would not fire their weapons first, but that tear gas would be considered an attack that would justify shooting back. "They don't want a peaceful resolution. They want to kill us," one occupier, Sandy Anderson, said in the live feed. But before the phone call ended, the occupiers said they would turn themselves into the FBI on Thursday morning. Just as the call ended, the authorities said that Clive Bundy, the Nevada cattleman whose sons Ammon and Ryan Bundy were among the original leaders of the Oregon occupation, had been arrested late Wednesday in Portland. An earlier message on the official Facebook page of Mr. Bundy's ranch had said that he would go to the site of the occupation. The arrest of the elder Mr. Bundy signaled a new stage in a decades-long fight between the United States government and the rancher, who stopped paying federal grazing fees in the early 1990s. In 2014, after federal officials tried to confiscate Mr. Bundy's cattle, professed militiamen flocked to his ranch in Bunkerville, Nevada, to face down the authorities. When the agents retreated, Mr. Bundy hailed it as a victory for those angered by federal regulation, and he has been seen as a hero by the Oregon occupiers and by people sympathetic to their cause. Clive Bundy's lawyer, Michael Arnold, said his client had been arrested at the Portland airport and would face a felony charge of conspiracy to impede officers of the United States from discharging their official duties, in connection with the 2014 standoff. Mal National Wildlife Refuge, about 6 hours from Portland, was taken over by a small band of armed militants on January 2. They demanded that two local ranchers, imprisoned on arson charges for a fire that spread to public lands, be released, and that federal lands that the occupiers said were improperly taken from local ranchers in decades past be returned to local or private control. On Wednesday, the FBI said in a statement, one of the occupiers rode an all-terrain vehicle outside the barricades at the refuge. Agents tried to approach the driver, the statement said, and he returned to the encampment at the refuge at high speed. Law enforcement officers then moved to contain the remaining occupiers by placing agents at barricades immediately ahead of and behind the area where the occupiers were camping. It has never been the FBI's desire to engage these armed occupiers in any way other than through dialogue, and to that end, the FBI has negotiated with patience and restraint in an effort to resolve the situation peacefully, Greg Bretzing, special agent in charge of the FBI in Oregon, said in a statement. However, we reached a point where it became necessary to take action in a way that best ensured the safety of those on the refuge, the law enforcement officers who are on scene, and the people of Harney County who live and work in this area. Advertisement. Continue reading the main story. Advertisement. Continue reading the main story. Later, Michelle Farr, a Nevada assemblywoman who has expressed sympathy for the occupiers, got on the phone with the four holdouts, as did an FBI negotiator the occupiers called Mark. Mark was on the phone only briefly. And Miss Farr spoke on the live stream to the occupiers, promising them that she was on her way to help negotiate their exit. Miss Farr encouraged the group to remain calm, put down their weapons and leave the refuge. "We don't need our weapons right now," she said, adding that the FBI would not fire on the occupiers. "The world is watching." Miss Farr, who is running for Congress from Nevada, transformed during the course of the live stream from an aspiring negotiator to something closer to a counselor, telling the panicked occupiers to remain calm, leading them in prayer and encouraging them to disarm. At another point, she encouraged them to invest in the political process, telling them, "We need your voice on a committee." The occupiers were unconvinced. Voices intermittently screamed in the background, "They don't care." Late Wednesday, The occupiers said they would be willing to turn themselves in, accompanied by Miss Foran and the evangelist Franklin Graham. On Thursday morning, Mr. Graham said he would travel to Oregon to try to mediate. "Last night I was on the phone with them for several hours, was able to have prayer with them, and they have said they would come out today," Mr. Graham said in a statement on his Facebook page. "I am on my way there and hope to be there by 7 a.m. their time." Mr. Graham's involvement appeared to be unfolding rapidly. On Wednesday night, a spokesman for Mr. Graham said he knew of no agreements between the evangelist and the FBI. Hours later, the spokesman also said that Mr. Graham had no plans at this point to go to Oregon. The remaining four occupiers repeatedly invoked the killing of Robert Finnicum, who was known as Lavoy, by federal agents during a January 26 traffic stop as a sign of the government's unwillingness to bring the standoff to a peaceful end. Mr. Finnicum was shot when he reached for a firearm, the FBI said. Ammon Bundy, the leader of the occupation, was arrested during the stop along with several other members of the group, including his brother, Ryan. On Wednesday night, Andy Dunbar, 53, who lives an eighth of a mile from the refuge with his wife, Vena, described the scene: a floodlight rig on a hill, and about five bearcats around the occupiers' camp.